Good afternoon, we are here at DCI 2017, but there is another very important exhibition. First, can you introduce yourself and explain briefly what is DAC?
Sure. Hi, I'm Anita Jacobson. I'm the general manager for DSA Exhibition and Conference. It is the 16th edition for this exhibition, and we will be celebrating our 30th anniversary next DSA, which is in April of 2018. This exhibition is known as the top 5 defense show in the world. We have some very good news for the next DSA. We are moving to a brand new venue. I think it's something that all the exhibitors have been looking forward to because the show has grown so much that we are wall bound at the last venue. And with this new venue, which is the MyTech Exhibition Centre, it's only 4 km from PWTC. We are taking this opportunity, which is very timely, and because we have the new venue, to launch what we call NetSec 2018, which is the National Security, or some may say Homeland Security, show. What we're going to do, because it's the first edition, we are going to use DSA to springboard and introduce this show and hold it alongside each other. But it will not be a feature, it will be a show by itself. And we're very much looking forward to it. As you can see, the new venue will be double the size of the previous venue. And what's good about it is that it's all the halls are together and it's on 3 levels. So you have got the car park under for all the exhibitors who are driving. We have sufficient car park, and you can enter from the car park, one entrance. This is the main entrance. We call it the south entrance, where the rest of the exhibitors and all will come. And this is specifically for VIP. So all our VIP delegation will drop off here. Okay? So this is the ground floor. This is all for the heavy and large companies. Okay? And then you go up via escalator lift to the second floor, okay, which is the lighter stuff, not so heavy vehicles. And finally, on the top floor, where it is all the smaller companies, like the 12 square meters and all that, they will be up there. And this one, this hall, will be dedicated for, as I mentioned earlier, the National Security Exhibition. This new venue has got fantastic logistic facilities. You have got a ramp that to the loading bay, where you can just drive the vehicles up straight into the loading bay, into the hall, on every level. Okay, and there's meeting rooms. There's large foyers outside for branding. We are also looking at the possibility of an area to do live demonstration during DSA.
Why is it so important to organize a defense exhibition, and especially in the ASEAN region?
First thing, you will find that there will be at least 30 international pavilions. So the whole world will come to DSA. Why? Because they want to sell to the ASEAN region. And there's so many things going on in the ASEAN region now. It is the region that everybody is looking at, is eyeballing. And the second part is that DSA brings all the VIP from around the region. So all these OEMs like BAE Systems, MBDA, so on and so forth, they don't have to go to every country. They just come to DSA and they are able to meet all their potential buyers for the ASEAN region.
In your point of view, what is unique in DSA?
I would say first and foremost is the VIP delegation management system. We don't only pay to bring the delegations in, which is about 350 delegations from around the region, around Asia Pacific and also Middle East and Turkey and so on. But we make it a point to deliver the particular delegation to each booth. So exhibitors, at the end of the day, that is their KPI. That is what they have to go back with, is written on investment. So exhibitor A will say, I want to see this 10 delegation. So if this delegation is visiting, we will make it our job to bring this delegation as much as possible to the booth. Secondly, it is the show, as I said, the regional show. So we have 42,000 visitors, trade visitor only, not open to public. Of all sorts, all levels, all ranks, all businesses, they come to DSA because they know this is where the business is.
There is also some conferences also at the exhibition?
Yes. We will be having once again the Putrajaya Forum, which is similar to Shangri-La Dialogue in Singapore. But this is the Malaysia edition, organised by the Ministry of Defence Malaysia, which will be talking about a very important topic, which is terrorism, Daesh and ISIS and all that. On top of that, that's very high level. We will also have a forum on HADR, humanitarian assistance and disaster relief. And the key highlight this time will be our cyber defense zone, where it's become a very hot topic, especially with what's been going on. And it is now one of the greatest threats, I think, in defense and security. So we are going to have quite a huge presence and participation from the cyber companies. And we're going to have conferences and seminars and talks in reference to cyber.
I think so. It's very important so for all defense exhibitions to have a lot of media from all over the world, and also for the exhibitors, because it's also a new approach to diffuse information about latest technology innovation. What can you say about media?
Well, if we don't have our media partners like yourself, I think it's very difficult for us, because in defense and security show, we cannot be advertising in the mass media. That is not our target market. We have to work with you, partner with the right media, so that we can get the message across to this industry, whoever is in the global industry, about DSA, the latest, the updates, the features, who's coming, and all that. So we have to partner with you in order to get them. Otherwise, we're not able to tell the rest of the world what to expect at DSA. So it's very important to partner with media partners such as Army Recognition. What is good about working with Army Recognition is also sometimes exhibition, if you use still photographs, people can't really understand what to expect. But with Army Recognition's web TV, visitors and exhibitors are able to see what is actually happening. So you become the eyes of DSA to the world.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.